direct to the poem. It starts with دعي الأيام تفعل ما تشاء. دعي الأيام. دع is the command form from ودع. And if we say ودع الشيء, he left it. ودعت, if I say ودعت هاتفي, I left my phone. That is why we have ودع. ودع is welfare. When you bid welfare, we call it ودع. Okay, so it says دع الأيام. Leave the days. Let the days do what they want. تفعل ما تشاء. Let the days do what they want. I let them pass. The days, what they want is they come. Today is Monday, tomorrow, Tuesday. The days keep going by like that. Let them go. دع الأيام تفعل ما تشاء. وطب نفسا. طب is from the, is also the command form from the imperative form from طاب. طاب is to be nice, to be cool, to be good. So he says وطب نفسا. And be cool with it. Let the days go by. Whatever they bring, be cool with it. Ready yourself for it. طب نفسا. So sometimes it's translated as and stay firm, which is very accurate. Or طب نفسا. And ready yourself for it. Embrace it. طب نفسا. إذا حكم القضاء. Embrace it when the decree has been said. إذا حكم القضاء. When the divine decree is set. So when you wake up and you hear somebody is dead, it's divine decree. Don't overdo the sadness. It is a divine decree that is bound to happen, and it has happened. So you prepare yourself with those things. Oh, it's supposed to happen, and it has happened. So it calms you down a bit. So دع الأيام تفعل ما تشاء وطب نفسا إذا حكم القضاء. When divine decree is set. Al-Qada is decree of fate. Okay, it says وَلَا تَجْزَعْ لِحَادِثَةِ اللَّيَالِ. لَا تَجْزَعْ. Do not be scared. Do not be incited to get scared. لَا تَجْزَعْ. جَزَعْ is fear. So it says لَا تَجْزَعْ لِحَادِثَةِ اللَّيَالِ. When we say hadithatil layali, what happens in the days? As the days go by, the incidents that happens, that is what we call them hadithatil layali. The occurrences of the nights basically means the incidents that comes and goes throughout the day. Oh, when you hear hadithatil layali, mostly used to mean bad events, bad incidents that happens within the day. Within the days and nights of man. The bad is the death, the accidents and all that. It says, وَلَا تَجْزَعْ. Do not get incited to be scared. لِحَادِثَةِ اللَّيَالِ. Why? He says, فَمَا لِحَوَادِثِ الدُّنْيَا بَقَاءُ. For the incidents of the world, it does not have persistence. That is what I said, I think yesterday's golden words, I have mentioned that the world itself is transient. So whatever happens in it is also transient. It will go by. It will just pass by. So it says, فَمَا لِحَوَادِثِ الدُّنْيَا. Hawadith is the plural of haditha. So it says, فَمَا لِحَوَادِثِ الدُّنْيَا بَقَاءُ. The occurrences of the world, everything that happens in the world, does not persist forever. Okay. بَقَاء is to persist. That is why when somebody dies, when you're greeting somebody who has lost a friend, a relative, you say al-baqa'u lillahi wahda. Abiding forever is for Allah alone. Al-baqa'u lillahi wahda. Okay, so we say again, wa kun rajulan ala al-ahwali jaldan. Kun rajulan, be a man. Rajulan here is using it as a symbol, like be strong, be bold. Wa kun rajulan, be a man. Ala al-ahwal. Ahwal is the plural of howl. Howl is terror, horror, anything that happens to put fear in you. It says, be a man towards such incidents, al-ahwal. Be a man towards anything that puts fear in you. He says, jaldan. When we say jalada, to put up with, to stay firm towards. Wa kun rajulan al-ahwali jaldan. Be a man towards terror and be firm. Was she matuke? As you do that, as you are staying firm and strong, was she matuke? She matun is character, personal disposition, how you behave. That is what we call shima, yani khuluk, attitude. Says, as you are strong towards this incident, was she matuke samahatu wal wafa'u. Make your character as samahatu, generosity, kindness, wal wafa'u. And also fulfilling promises. When we say wafa, staying honest. Wafa, honesty. When you go on a deal with somebody, fulfill it. Okay, so he says, as problems are coming, stay strong. And also make your character or what you are known for to be kindness and also pardoning. As samahatu, you pardon a lot, show kindness. Okay, he says in the fourth bait, وَإِن كَثُرَتْ عُيُوبُكَ فِي الْبَرَايَا. When your fault or your shortcomings, عُيُوب is the plural of عَيْب, which means flaw, sin, or errors, wrongdoings. It says, إِن كَثُرَتْ عُيُوبُكَ. When your wrongs or your errors or your sins become a lot, فِي الْبَرَايَا. Al-Baraya is the creation, people. If everybody starts to see you as bad, you are doing bad stuff, what do you do? He says, وَسَرَّكَ أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهَا غِطَاءُ. And it excites you, or it would make you happy, that all this, your fault, should have a cover, should be concealed. غِطَاء is cover. Anything you use to cover something, a cup, a bowl, is غِطَاء. If you cover anything like that, that you used to cover is guitar. He says, وَسَرَّكَ أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهَا غِطَاءُ. And it will have been, you would have been excited that all these your flaws have a cover. That is, they are concealed. People do not see you as bad anymore. What do you do? Then he says, تَسَتَّرْ بِالسَّخَاءِ فَقُلُّ عَيْبٍ يُغَطِّيهَا كَمَا قِيلَ السَّخَاءُ. تَسَتَّرْ, I seek cover. بسخاء, with generosity. سخاء, giving a lot, generosity. So he says, تسطر بسخاء. Cover your flaws with giving, generosity, munificence. فكل عيب, because every flaw, يغطيها, is covered, كما قيل, as said, السخاء, by generosity. Now, if you're a bad person, everybody is seeing you as a bad person, and you want to cover that bad trait of yours, what do? You start being kind, showing kindness to people. Pay this one school fees, find some orphan, take care of them, try to help bad poor people and all that, those up, those down, bring them up. Soon, every language about you will change. Everybody will start speaking good of you. So that is what Imam Shafi'i is advising. وَإِنْ كَثُرَتْ عُيُوبُكَ فِي الْبَرَايَا وَسَرَّكَ أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهَا غِطَاءُ تَسَتَّرْ بِالسَّخَاءِ فَكُلُّ عَيْبٍ يُغَطِّيهَا كَمَا قِيلَ السَّخَاءُ. Okay, he says, وَلَا تُرِ لِلْعَادِي قَدْ تُذُلًا. وَلَا تُرِ. Turi is from ara, to show. The command verb, he's saying, لَا تُرِ, do not show. لِلْعَادِي, to your enemies. قَدْ تُ, ever. Never show to your enemies dhullan, lowliness. Never see your enemy and go all humble, showing some low character. No. The enemy rather oppresses you with that. So he says, لَا تُ وَلَا تُرِ لِلْعَادِ قَدْ تُ dhullan. Do not show humility or lowliness or debaseness to your enemies. فَإِنَّ شَمَاتَةَ الْعَادَ بَلَاءُ. For the attacks of enemies is a calamity, bala'u. So when you go debased like that and your enemy sees you debased, they get the chance to hit at you, insult you more, always put bad stuff on you, attack you from all angles. He says, don't give them this chance. It is a calamity, it is a bala'u. Do not do that. Okay. And then in the next bite, he says, وَلَا تَرُجُ السَّمَاحَةَ مِنْ بَخِيلٍ فَمَا فِي النَّارِ لِلزَّمْآنِ مَاءُ. Imam Shafi, for the record, speaks wisdoms. So you can just use all his lines as wise sayings at any moment in time when the need arises. Says wala taruju. Taruju is from raja, to seek, to hope for. Says wala taruju samahata. Do not hope for kindness min bakhilin, from the stingy person. Do not be there knowing somebody is very stingy, then you are hoping so much that the person will give you something. It's the basis humor. Fama finnari, for there is no fama finnari li zam'ani ma'u. A zam'an is somebody who is thirsty. So he's saying that the thirsty person does not have water in the fire. What is he saying? The thirsty water cannot provide, fire cannot provide water for the thirsty person. So if somebody is thirsty, he doesn't go to the fire to seek water. Even if there is water on the fire, you don't seek that hot water to drink. So there is nothing about the fire to that can quench your thirst. So he's telling you that he's comparing the stingy person to the fire and your need to somebody who is thirsty. وَلَا تَرُجُ السَّمَاحَةَ مِنْ بَخِيلٍ فَمَا فِي النَّارِ لِلزَّمْآنِ مَاءٌ. Okay. He says, وَرِزْقُكَ, and your wealth, لَيْسَ يُنْقِسُهُ التَّأَنِّي, and your wealth is not decreased by patience, working carefully. يُنْقِسُ, to reduce. Rizq, of course, is wealth. التَّأَنِّي, to be doing things carefully, a bit slowly, cautiously. So doing cautiously, not doing hasty things, does not reduce your wealth. As people think, you have to be fast, go here and there, your body has to be moving. That is not how we drag wealth into our lives. That's what he's telling you. وَرِزْقُكَ لَيْسَ يُنْقِسُهُ التَّأَنِّي. Being careful does not reduce your wealth. Says وَلَيْسَ يَزِيدُ الرِّزْقِ, وَلَيْسَ يَزِيدُ فِي الرِّزْقِ الْعَنَاءُ. Al-ana is stress, tiredness, hastiness. Says, you doing slow and careful does not reduce your wealth. Neither does you being hasty and stressing more increase your wealth. Of course, those in the offices and the air conditions would have been poorer, and those on the streets hustling would have been more rich. So he is telling, cautioning you that these are not the determinants of wealth. Okay. وَلَا حُزْنٌ يَدُومُ وَلَا سُرُورٌ. حُزْنٌ, sadness, لَا يَدُومُ, does not persist forever. وَلَا سُرُورٌ, neither does joy persist. وَلَا بُؤْسٌ, hardship, بُؤْسٌ, does not also persist. وَلَا بُؤْسٌ عَلَيْكَ وَلَا رَخَاءُ. بُؤْسٌ, hardship, does not persist on you forever. وَلَا رَخَاءُ, neither does luxury, cool life, persist. So وَلَا حُزْنٌ يَدُومُ وَلَا سُرُورُ, وَلَا بُؤْسٌ عَلَيْكَ وَرَخَاءُ, وَلَا بُؤْسٌ عَلَيْكَ وَلَا رَخَاءُ. And he says, إِذَا مَا كُنْتَ ذَا قَلْبٍ قَنُوءُ فَأَنْتَ وَمَالِكُ الدُّنْيَا سَوَاءُ. إِذَا مَا كُنْتَ, if you are ذَا قَلْبٍ قَنُوءٍ, if you are someone with a heart of contentment, you are contented with what you have, says, فَأَنْتَ, for you, وَمَالِقُ الدُّنْيَا, and the one who owns the world. Those people who are very wealthy, they kind of own the world. And you and those who own the world, سَوَاءُ, are the same. Because whatever you have, I don't care. I think I'm okay. So at the end of the day, we are all the same. Okay. And he says, وَمَنْ نَزَلَتْ بِسَاحَتِهِ الْمَنَايَا. Saha, sahatun, a field, horizon. So وَمَنْ نَزَلَتْ بِسَاحَتِهِ الْمَنَايَا. Manaya is the plural of maniya, which is death. So manaya, death, the same way, we don't just bother pluralizing it. Whoever that death visits, his horizon or his zone, his space, asaha, field. So if death visits your field, he says, fala ardun taqihi, no earth will save this person. If death visits you, No earth, فلا أرض تقيه. No land will protect you. No land protects that such a person. ولا سماء. Neither does any form of sky protect you. If death comes to you, you can travel to wherever it will take you. If death comes to you, you can fly up wherever you want in the sky, it will take you. That is what he means by ومن نزلت بساحته المنايا فلا أرض تقيه ولا سماء. Then he says وأرض الله واسعة and the land of Allah is wide. أي فسيحة, very wide. ولكن but then إذا نزل القضاء. Here in the poem he's taking off the Hamza because of the meters. إذا نزل القضاء, if the decree descends, ضاق الفضاء, space, open space becomes narrow. When it's time for you to go, you cannot move anywhere, you will just be taken. ضاق الفضاء, open space becomes narrow. And he says the last bait, دع الأيام تقدر كل حين. Let the days go by and keep deceiving, keep cheating, keep doing what it wants. تقدر, to deceive, to cheat. Let the days go by and cheat and deceive however they want. فما يغني عن الموت الدواء. For medicine does not avail a person of anything when death comes. فما يغني عن الموت الدواء. Medicine or cure does not help in any way when death visits. Okay, so this brings us to the end of that qasida. I think it is the first poem in his Diwan, Diwan Imam Shafi'i. You can download it and then check the verses out. And I hope our explanation has done some good. I would like to read it again. I enjoy this bait a lot, this qasida a lot. It says, دع الأيام تفعل ما تشاء وطب نفسا إذا حكم القضاء ولا تجزع لحادثة الليالي فما لحوادث الدنيا بقاء وكن رجلا على الأهوال جلدا وشيمتك السماحة والوفاء وإن كثرت عيوبك في البرايا وسرك أن يكون لها غطاء تستر بالسخاء فكل عيب يغطيه كما قيل السخاء ولا تري للعاد قد تذلا فإن شماتة العاد بلاء ولا ترجو السماحة من بخيل فما في النار للظمآن ماء ورزقك ليس ينقصه التأني وليس يزيد في الرزق العناء ولا حزن يدوم ولا سرور ولا بؤس عليك ولا رخاء إذا ما كنت ذا قلب قنوء فأنت ومالك الدنيا سواء ومن نزلت بساحته المنايا فلا أرض تقيه ولا سماء وأرض الله واسعة ولكن إذا نزل القضاء ضاق الفضاء دع الأيام تقدر كل حين فما يغني عن الموت الدواء السلام عليكم.